Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today is going to be kind of the last, hopefully not ever the last, video in my bookshelf tour, going through all of the books on my shelf. If you haven't seen the first two videos in this series, which cover this shelf and this shelf, please do so. In case you also haven't noticed, it was my birthday last week, so that's why I have all my birthday cards up here. Today is probably going to end up being the longest video in this series, simply because there is the most books. I recently reorganized this shelf and it now has a lot more books on it than it did before, but I'm gonna try and go through this as quickly as possible for you. We're gonna start on this side and then just work our way across. First book is Warrior by Jennifer Fallon. If you haven't read her Medallion series or the Hithrin Chronicle, which is what this book is a part of, I highly recommend them. This is part of the Wolfblade trilogy about one of the main characters in her first series and like about him and his mom. And then there is another trilogy after that, but I really prefer those two trilogies to the first one. I always really liked this person as a character, and it was really interesting to see some of the world building that went on behind this book. This is the second book in this trilogy. The first one is called Wolfblade, so you should definitely pick that up before you pick up this, but highly recommend. So next we have Sharon Shin, who has already made an appearance in my top shelf. She is hands down one of my favorite fantasy authors. In particular, her Angelica books are amazing and I highly recommend them. They are a loosely tied together series set on a world and they kind of seem fantasy, but then they're also kind of science fiction without trying to ruin the plot. One of my favorite series by her. So we have Angelica, which is sort of a prequel to the main book that was written first, which is called Archangel. And then we have Angel Seeker, which is a book that's directly after the first book she wrote in the series called Archangel, but it's about different characters. This is definitely one of my favorite books in that series, and this one I like and is good to read because it's part of the series, but it's not my favorite. The Shape Changer's Wife I bought on a whim because I really like her books and I wanted to read something, and I haven't finished it yet, but it has this problem where the main character is a guy, and I sometimes struggle to read books with guys as the main character, so I haven't managed to finish this yet, but I will at some point. Next we have Dealing with Dragons by Patricia C. Reed. This is a really great young adult fantasy book. The entire series by her stuck with me throughout when I first read it as a teenager to now, and I would still reread this even if it's quite a small book. And clearly I've put it through its paces while it's been in my collection. These are really great because she really takes the whole trope of a lot of fairy tale stories and she sets it into a fantasy world, and then the people in this world kind of defy those norms, and she's got lots of strong female characters and they're really good. So I highly recommend these. Empress by Karen Miller. I've read I think one other book by her, and I bought this and I made it most of the way through. I'm almost finished it. I haven't finished it yet. I can't really say that I enjoyed this book because I think it's a hard book to enjoy because it's about the villain of the series, and it's kind of like a prequel and backstory to how the villain of the series became that way, which is a really interesting concept, and that's what I liked about it. But that being said, because it's a villain, it can be a bit difficult to read. But if you're looking for something that's a little bit unusual and not what you would typically expect, I would definitely recommend this book. Next are some of the books that I have by Mercedes Lackey. I have more than this, but they're clearly either on ebook or in Canada. Mercedes Lackey, if you don't already know who she is, I mean, you need to find out. She's one of the, I would say, seminal and like first really big fantasy authors. Her Valdemar series, I'm sure, has inspired so many of this next generation of fantasy writers that is coming out. She writes people across the entire spectrum. Women, men, people who are straight, people who are gay, etc. And like everything that I've read by her, I've liked. I actually in particularly loved her Elvenblood series with Andra Norton, who is another pioneer female fantasy writer who's unfortunately passed away, but the series, for whatever reason, made it to 3 books, left it on a cliffhanger, and never went to 4. I would love if she could just finish it, or at least tell us what was supposed to happen one day, but you never know, maybe eventually, with all the stuff that's going on with self-publishing at the moment, she'll be able to release something eventually. But if you're going to start anywhere with her, I would recommend her first series, which is this one. It's called The Heralds of Valdemar. These are the second and third book in this trilogy. The first one is called Arrows of the Queen. It's about Talia. She features in a lot of other books besides this trilogy, but this trilogy is about her. Then we also have this book, which is actually 3 books in one. This is the Mage Winds trilogy, which features characters from Valdemar and is a hefty read if you're looking for something to occupy your time. Then we have Closer to Home. This is the Harold spy books. So these are also set in Valdemar, but in a different time. It's actually before all of these other books. A main character named Mags, who is a Harold, but he also has talents as a spy and his adventures in doing this. So if you're looking for something written by her that's about a male character primarily, this is a good series to start with. The other two, the main characters are women. Now we have Kate Elliott's Crown of Stars series. So these are Volume 7 and Volume 3, which I bought when I was making my way through this series because they either weren't available through the library or ebook or whatever. I started reading this series because I actually love, love, love her Jaran series, or Jaran, however you say it. The first book in particular I've reread and I just, oh, it's probably one of my favorite books. So I was looking for more to read and this series is recommended. It is a good series. The world building is crazy, but I will say that it can be very difficult to read at times. Some of the things that happen to these characters are difficult to read through. These characters are real people. I think she's made a real effort to write characters that don't just bounce back from their traumas. They are affected by it and it affects their actions and their decisions after these things happen to them. But if you're looking for a long, complete fantasy series with diverse characters as well, I would highly recommend these books. Okay, we've got Truth Witch by Susan Denard. I have finished this book and I do intend on buying the next one, and there are, I think, at least one or two more books in this series, but I've just not gotten around it because I've had other stuff on my list that I've wanted to read more. For me, it's not quite a typical young adult fantasy because it's not just, you know, girls in trouble, girl has meet cute, finds boy, saves the world. There does seem to be some layers of complexity to it, which I appreciate, and is very much also about the friendship of two girls, which I think is a good example to set in a fantasy book. If you're looking for a just good standard fantasy young adult read, recommend this one. And now we have another book by Juliette Marillier, who again has featured elsewhere on my bookcase. This is Ravenflight, which is a Shadowfell novel, which is a fantasy series that's kind of set in like an alternate fantasy Scotland. I can't say that the Shadowfell series in particular spoke to me. I definitely prefer her Seven Waters series. That's my favorite series that she's written, but these are still good books if you're looking for something more by her or something that's maybe a bit more young adult oriented. All right, The Reluctant Queen by Sarah Beth Thirst. I've read a couple other books by her and I did enjoy this book when I read it, but not particularly enough to pick up the sequel yet. But this is very much about a very kind of matriarchal society where your entire environment attacks you and the only people that can control the spirits of that environment are women. And so you get these queens that rule over people because they can control all of the demons in their territory. And then you've got girls training to become heirs, queens, etc. And this book is about one of those girls who is training to do that. The Copper Crown by Patricia Keenly Morrison, who actually as an author I think is more famous for the fact that she married Jim Morrison in like a hand fasting ceremony. This is like a fantasy space ethic that draws upon the idea that the Celts were taken from Earth in giant spaceships along with a couple other civilizations like the Lost Tribes of Israel out into space, and then at a later point they reunite with humans. But in the meantime, they've built this great Celtic-based civilization. So this book very, very much heavily draws upon a lot of Celtic and pagan themes. So this is the first book in the trilogy, and I think there's actually intended to be more than three books in this series, but it never got finished, or they didn't want to publish it for whatever reason. So if you're looking for kind of something that crosses sci-fi elements with ancient British, Irish, Celtic, paganism, good book to pick up. And then we have the classic sci-fi books here, Dune Messiah and Children of Dune by Frank Herbert. I also do have Dune the book and I've read it, but it's in Canada. I watched the David Lynch Dune film when I was probably like 10 and didn't understand, I would say 75% of what was going on, but I liked the look of it. And I watched the film repeatedly over the years. And then it only was when I was maybe in my early 20s, I think probably about 23, 24, that I read the original Dune, which made the movie make so much more sense. Also, Dune is an excellent book. I would say that it is one of those like landmark early science fiction books that has had an effect on pretty much everything since then. It's very well thought out. I really enjoy the premise of it. And there's a new movie about the main book by Denis Villeneuve featuring a bunch of really famous movie stars that is supposed to be coming out in December about it. So if you have time, definitely read Dune, the book, before you watch the movie, because I guarantee it will make the movie better for you because there is so much subtext that you will be able to understand. Okay, so we've covered the top row here. We're now gonna go on to the bottom. So the first book we have here is The Second Empress by Michelle Moran, who is one of my favorite historical fiction authors. This is about the second wife of Emperor Napoleon, Marie Louise Habsburg, who was the daughter of the Emperor of the Austrian Empire. She married Napoleon after he cast aside Josephine, had his only son, and this book is very much about her life being married to Napoleon and then the aftermath. Really great book about someone that generally gets swept aside when you're reading about Napoleon. People like to focus a bit more on Napoleon himself, Josephine, or his many mistresses. Another author that's made an appearance earlier in this series, The Chosen Queen by Joanna Courtney. So this is part of a trilogy that centers around the women of the conquest of England. So this is about Edith, who is a noblewoman that was married to the King of Wales and then ended up marrying Harold Godwinson, who was the main challenger that William the Conqueror slew in 1066 when he took the throne. And so this is about her life. So if you're looking to read a bit more about the conquest, great book to do so. All right, so next we have The Samurai's Daughter by Leslie Downer, who is a author that has extensively studied Japan. She's lived in Japan studying geisha, and she's written multiple books about Japan. So this book is set in the 1870s and is about the daughter of a famous general who also features in that movie The Last Samurai with Tom Cruise and his mistress, and is about her life experiencing the Civil War of Japan. Meet myself not being an expert in Japan or Japan's history, I enjoyed this book. I felt like she did her research well and she portrayed things well, and I would recommend both this book and the other ones that she's written as well. The Seal Woman's Gift by Sally Magnusson, who's actually the daughter of Magnus Magnusson, the historian who I have a much bigger book of up here. This is a historical fiction novel that, while not my favorite, I found really interesting because it's actually based on a true story. In 1627, when pirates raided the coast of Iceland and took 400 people captive and brought them back to Algiers. Among these captives is a pastor, his pregnant wife, and their children. And this book is very much more so about the wife and her experience after her husband gets set free and goes back to try and raise money to free the rest of his family from slavery. So her experience living as a slave in Algiers in the 1600s. And I don't really want to give you a spoiler. It doesn't have the ending that you think it does, but it's still really interesting and really well researched. All right, The Empress by Meg Clothier. I really enjoyed this book. So this is set in the late 1100s and is about a French princess called Agnes, who was sent at the age of 13 to the Byzantine Empire to marry the emperor, and then thereafter lived her life there. Someone who isn't, I think, very extensively talked about in history, but was very interesting that as a Western princess went to an Eastern kingdom to marry, having her become an empress, she's the only one to have done that, which I thought was quite cool. She also has another book about Georgia and a queen of Georgia, which I would love to read, but I've had a really difficult time finding. This is a very interesting outlier story and a lot happens in it, and I highly recommend this book. Six Tudor Queens, Catherine of Aragon by Alison Weir. So Alison Weir is a historian who writes both nonfiction and fiction books about England, and particularly tends to focus on queens of England and the Tudors in particular. So she has a series about each of the wives of Henry VIII, and this is the first one. It's excellently researched, it's a good book, but personally, I'm kind of sick of reading about the Tudors, so I don't know if I enjoyed this maybe as much as I could have, because I feel like at this point I've read Catherine of Aragon's story so many times. There's only so many ways that you can tell it. But if you're looking for a good and well-researched historic fic book about Henry VIII and his wives, these books are definitely ones that I would recommend for that. Here Be Dragons by Sharon Penman. This was given to me by the finds manager at my archaeological company, which she gave to me because she knows I love historic fiction, and when she gave it to me, she said that it is probably one of the best historic fiction books she's read. It's excellently researched and reading it really puts you into that context of when it is set, and I would have to 100% agree with her. I've also been reading the second book in this kind of like series. It's not quite a series. I'm sure you could read all of these books independently, but they are kind of set one after the other. And I don't enjoy it as much, but I think that's because of the character that it's based on, not necessarily the strength of the writing. So Here Be Dragons is about Joanna, who is an illegitimate daughter of King John of England, who got sent to Wales to marry a Welsh prince and has to kind of negotiate this middle ground of being loyal to her husband, but also to her father, especially at a time when Wales was still independent of the Kingdom of England and they did have armed conflict and her father or her husband lead armies against each other. How do you negotiate that battleground between your father who you love and your husband who you love? Honestly, if you're looking for a good historic fiction, please, please read this. This book is amazing. Belgravia by Julian Fellowes. This is okay. It's predictable. I saw the ending coming from a mile away. TV show has been made about it recently that's gone on the TV. He's the guy who made Downton Abbey. If you like Downton Abbey, you should read this book. The Heir of Night by Helen Lowe. I don't remember anything about this book. I started reading it at some point. I clearly never finished it. I don't particularly know why. I should try to reread it. Otherwise, it will probably go in my donations pile. The Wrath and the Dawn. This is a young adult book about Shahrazad, famous from 1001 Nights. It is trying to give it a bit of a different spin. I liked it, but again, I didn't finish it, so I clearly got a little bit bored towards the end, but there is a sequel. I think it's a duology. I don't think it's just one book, but if you're looking for a book that's a bit more Eastern Persian, non-Western fantasy, historic fic, whatever you want to call it, then this would be a good book for that. So I forgot that I actually had this one when I was showing you the other one earlier, but this is another Juliet Morelli book, The Harp of Kings, which is about a group of people training to become elite warriors in Dark Ages-ish Ireland. I don't think you ever really find out what year these books are set, but it's about them. They're going to a kingdom where a harp has been stolen and they're trying to recover the harp, and shenanigans ensue. This is not a direct sequel of another series that this author did, but it features cameos, I would say, from characters from other series that she's done. And so, as with anything Juliet Morelli, I would recommend picking this up. But again, this is not my favorite series that she's done. That being said, I like everything by her. The Blood Curse by Emily Gee. I don't even know if I finished this book. It says it's this final book in this series, and I definitely read the first two novels of this, although where they are, I couldn't tell you. But I don't remember much about it, so I can't really say whether or not I recommend it or not. This is The Empress Game by Rhonda Mason. This is another kind of like meh science fiction book that I've read. It's very like kind of gladiatorial. It's about winning a tournament of ritualized combat in order to become an empress. And it's about someone who's a good fighter who gets disguised as one of the entrants in order to win it because the person can't fight. It was okay. It didn't blow me away, but it also was good enough for me to finish. Throne of the Crescent Moon. I picked this up and I really should finish it, but I got partway through, as you can see by the dog ear. Don't come at me. I'm one of those people that I've gotten better at not doing it, but I used to dog ear books all the time. And it's one of those things where I think part of the reason why I kind of lost interest is because I think there's multiple main characters and they're not all women. So I just wasn't as interested as I might have been. That being said, I've heard good things about it, so on my list to finish at some point. The Daylight War by Peter V. Brett. This is the third book in this series, and I honestly haven't read past this book. Picked this series up, and at first I kind of enjoyed it, but then it's kind of gone on a downhill slope for me since then. I found it, I think, to be too gruesome, and it's just constantly filled with like fighting, which, I mean, I just don't find that as interesting a thing to read about, is lots of fight scenes. I liked this book out of all of them in particular because it's partly from a female perspective, and I found that interesting. But I don't know, it kind of seems like this story, like, they just can't win. and they're just gearing up for everyone to die at the end. Not necessarily saying that's what happens, because obviously I don't know, but I kind of lost interest in the series after this book. A Turn of Light by Julie E. Cerznetta. I don't know if I'm saying that right. With my T-Rex book clip bookmark thing, which I quite like. And it's signed by the author. So I've read a lot of her other science fiction series, The Clan Chronicles, which I enjoyed more than this book. I've actually attempted to read this book multiple times, and as you can see, I've never finished it. And I don't really know why, because I really like her other stuff, but her fantasy novels just, for whatever reason, aren't really working for me, or maybe I've just not tried hard enough, but I just can't really get into this one, and I really want to finish it because I really like this author, but I've had a really hard time getting into this book. Okay, two chonkers. We're almost at the end, guys. Brandon Sanderson's Stormlight Archive, the first two books in this. So if you read fantasy and you don't know who Brandon Sanderson is, you don't really read fantasy if you haven't heard about him. He is an excellent author, and certainly, at least in my opinion, a worthy successor to someone like Robert Jordan. He is very famous for having finished Robert Jordan's Wheel of Time series after he passed away. I think that he did an excellent job at it. I think I'm a bit of an outlier in that I don't really love his Mistborn series, but I loved the book Warbreaker. The first book I ever read by him was Elantris, which is very good. And I love this series that he's doing, which is his big epic fantasy series. So he's got three books in this so far. I have paperback copies of the first two. I will buy a paperback copy of the third eventually. Maybe I'll just go do that today. I've read all of them because they're coming out in hardcover, which is very expensive now. I have read the last book from the library rather than buying it myself, but I will buy it. And I look forward to the next entrance in the series and seeing where this is going. One of the things I really love about this series, besides the cover art, because I am such a sucker for cover art, is that similar to Kate Elliott's stuff, he really tries to write characters that aren't perfect. So they have personality flaws, they've had things happen to them in their lives that are traumatic, and these books are really about them and how they deal with that trauma and how it shapes them as a person. I love that concept that he writes like real people, and it's just great, and his world building is excellent, and I look forward to seeing to where the series is going to go. All right, last but not least, The Red Sister by Mark Lawrence, which is the first book of The Ancestor. Now, I have never actually read anything else by Mark Lawrence. I know that he's got a book out there called Prince of Thorns and another series or two. And this one, I was kind of like, oh, I don't know if I'll like this. And I started reading it, and I was like, for the first maybe couple chapters, I was like, I don't really know what's going on here. But this series, the more I read it, the better it got. It is a new world, a new series for him. I really enjoyed the characters that he has in this. They're very unique. They're not characters that I've read before, if that makes any sense. I really, really enjoyed the Book of the Ancestor series. I actually just finished The Girl in the Stars, which is a new trilogy, I think, or new series set in the same world but about different characters, which I didn't like as much, but I highly, highly recommend these books, especially if you're just starting with Mark Lawrence. I will say they are gory. This is not a series I would recommend for children or young teenagers, but it is a really, really good series. So this is kind of like my paperback mass market shelf and everything that's on it so far. As you can see, quite a diverse range, but still my typical historic fiction, fantasy, sci-fi books. I hope that some of you have maybe gotten some suggestions for some things to read off of this shelf. If I had to pick something to recommend to everybody, if it's fantasy, I'm gonna have to go with Brandon Sanderson's Stormlight Archive. If you're looking for science fiction, you have to read Frank Herbert's Dune series, at least the first one. You have to read Dune. It is an excellent novel. And if you're going for historic fiction, Here Be Dragons by Sharon Penman. So those are my kind of three genre recommendations out of this shelf. If you have any recommendations for me based upon what you've seen of my bookshelf already, please put them in the comments down below. So that's kind of the entirety of my casual reading shelf at the moment. Obviously, this isn't my entire collection. I would say that maybe 70% of my collection's at my parents' house, 20% of it's on my Kindle, and then 10% of it is here, but I'm confined by space, so Unfortunately, I can't show you more at the moment. As I said, it was also just recently my birthday, so I got a bunch of books for my birthday, which I'm excited to make my way through. I've just finished last night The Girl in the Stars, and then I've got three more, including Empire of Gold, which is the last book in the S.A. Chakraborty series. So I'm so excited to read this, but I'm kind of like saving it because I just want to like savor it. And I also kind of don't want it to end. So if I don't read it, it doesn't end. If you guys are interested in seeing what I thought of these, all these new books, once I finish them, let me know in the comments and I will definitely do a video on that. As you can maybe tell, I love talking about books. So if people want the content, I will provide it. Maybe you've come away with some books that you want to try. Maybe you have some books recommended to me. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, as usual, please put them down in the comment box below. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. And if you want to see more from me, check out anything else that's on my channel. And please subscribe and hit the bell so that you get notified when I put out new videos. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you next time. Bye!